This sight surely is worrisome. I wonder what teacher will do with the pictures he took. Perhaps he will talk about them in his class.
Ugh, what a bad weather. It's too hot. I wish I was by a beach. Sea beach? I will go there.
Timul, I went to the beach yesterday and I took some photos there. Some of them are nice, but some of them made me really feel bad. Kids, take a look at these pictures.
Sir, what happened to those trees?
And why those trees on the shore look like they're dying?
Maybe a large wave ate them.
Yes, Timul, you're partly correct. Those trees have been affected by a rising tide, which is caused by a phenomenon called global warming.
Global warming? What's that? Warming of the earth?
Yes, Timul, once again you got it right. Global warming is the increased heating of the Earth's temperature, causing our climate to change.
Global warming? Climate change? They sure sound serious.
Indeed, children. Global warming and climate change have been seriously causing problems in our lives and environment.
But sir, how does global warming happen?
Before we can discuss global warming, I think first you need to understand the normal condition of the Earth. The Earth receives most of its energy, called radiation, from the sun. The incoming solar or sun energy passes right through the atmosphere in the air surrounding the Earth. The Earth's surface absorbs the solar energy and releases it back to the atmosphere as heat radiation, some of which goes right back into the space. But some of the heat radiation released back to the Earth is absorbed by the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere and sent back towards the Earth's surface. That warms the Earth. This is called the greenhouse effect.
Greenhouse gases? What a weird name. What are these?
The atmosphere of the Earth normally has greenhouse gases. The three main gases in the atmosphere that contribute to the greenhouse effect are carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor. The greenhouse gas trap heat, making the Earth warmer. Moderate amount of greenhouse gases in Earth's atmosphere makes the global temperature habitably comfortable for the living things. We can simply say that moderate greenhouse effect keeps Earth in moderate temperature. But from 200 years ago, greenhouse gases, mainly carbon dioxide, have been rapidly increasing by human activities. Our energy needs become bigger as our population grows larger. Also, as we seek more comfortable lives, such as using cars, using air conditioning system, and disposable product, we produce too much pollution as a bad result. Pollution creates increased amount of greenhouse gases in Earth's atmosphere. This causes breaking of the heat exchange balance and rise of temperature. This phenomenon is called global warming. Global warming causes climates around the world to change, and we all know it means trouble, environmental trouble.
Sir, those pictures of strange uprooted trees are one of the environmental problems, aren't they?
Yes, Badal, this is one of the environmental trouble caused by temperature rise. In the past 100 years, average global air temperature has risen from 0.7 to 0.8 degrees Celsius. As you can see here, because of the increased warming of the Earth, ice is melting, especially in the Earth's polar region. Then this melted water flows into the ocean. And it is not negligible that ocean water itself expands as it gets warmer. This causes the sea level to rise. And in the past 100 years, average global sea level has risen about 20 centimeters.
I don't see why we need to be worried about the 0.7 degree temperature increase and 20 centimeter sea level rise. They're too little.
No, Timul. Even though this temperature rise is negligible for human, it has great impact on the lives of animal and crops. And though the temperature increase and sea level rise seems insignificant, as you can see here, small amount of sea level rise causes large area of water rising in case of shallow shore. This destructs the lives of shoreline dwellers such as human, animal, plants, including trees.
I don't care. I like warm ocean. It's fun to swim in warm ocean.
No, Timul. Warming up of the ocean means more trouble. Ocean normally affects our climates. But because of global warming, the ocean is getting heated up abnormally. This is causing formation of more destructive cyclone. Not only that, we have already started to experience abnormal weathers more often. Longer droughts, heavier rainfall, and more extreme cold waves and heat waves.
Oh no, I'm worried so many disasters are caused by global warming. What should we do?
Children, the good news is we can do something about the global warming, but we must do it promptly because the world has already been suffering. Global warming has been happening and is quickly progressing because of people's carelessness. Knowing the sources of greenhouse gases and minimizing or controlling them is the best effort against global warming. The first thing we can do is to cut down our use of fuel and stop burning trash that can produce more greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Second, we can plant more trees. Trees absorb carbon dioxide, which is one of the greenhouse gases. We can also tell our parents and the people we know that cutting down trees for fuel is bad. Without a restoration plan, we are making the earth warmer by lessening the number of trees that could absorb carbon dioxide. Third, we can encourage our parents to use environmentally friendly products than using plastic. Though these things are small steps, if we do it together, I'm sure we can do a difference and help our world against global warming.
Why don't we start planting trees now? Let's go and plant trees.
Sure, Timul. I'm glad you're now taking part in helping our environment. This small tree will grow to be a big tree in many years to come. It'll do its job very well, protecting our environment from global warming. And do you know what is the good part of growing up? As you grow up, just like this tree, then you'll know your part in protecting the environment. Some of you will become scientists, others will be engineers, and some of you will work with the government. Whatever you will become, I'm pretty sure, to make this world a better place to live, you'll play your part.
I know what I'll become. I'll become a good teacher. I'll teach my students how to take care of the world, just like our teacher.
Really wonderful, Timul. Always remember, if we work together, we can make a better world. Right, kids?
Yes, we can make a better world.
What a great day it is for the children in teacher's class. They have learned a lot about global warming and climate change. What about you, kids? Do you want to play your role in managing climate change? Let's start right from this moment. Every single person helping the earth is a great force when we are all together.